Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, with another in the series on the 1857 phone autograph. Well, I've just soldered the lateral stylus to the vertical stylus, so the machine is basically ready to test. Whether it's going to work is problematical. The design is really, really inefficient on this machine, and my major concern is, of course, this pivot. And I'm thinking I'm probably going to lose all of my motion in the pivot itself. So I'm going to have to study this, see how it works, do some tests, and either improve it or change it. I might make this stylus out of one piece instead of soldering it together. It's such a really, really tiny, tiny wire. And this is tempered copper, so it is really, really stiff. It doesn't bend like a copper wire does. It's almost like spring steel, except it's made of copper, of course. But as you can see, they're connected together. And you're definitely hearing the vibrations coming from the diaphragm. So now it's just a matter of testing it and seeing if it will actually scribe a modulated line. No way to tell. The only way to tell is to actually do it and see. So I'm concerned about this hinge. I'm also waiting to see how well this soldered joint is going to stand up. There's going to be a lot of pressure on this. Well, there's going to be some pressure on it as it scribes the paper. So I'll just have to wait and see how that holds up. Like I said, I might have to just remake this entire piece out of one single piece of copper. We shall see. Anyway, so technically the machine is ready to record. I'm going to try to do an experiment later tonight to see if I can actually scribe a line, a modulated line on paper. So it's got its new diaphragm, new gaskets, new mounting procedure, new vertical stylus, new lateral stylus. Technically, the machine is now an operating phonautograph. The only way to see how well it works, of course, is to do a test on a piece of blackened paper and see. And there's another problem there, is that I might actually have to use a kerosene lamp and blacken some paper, because this has to touch it really, really lightly to get any motion. And a piece of smoked paper, of course, smudges really easily, so it doesn't take very much downforce energy to scribe into it. So a lot of parameters that I have to experiment with to see if the machine will work at all. And of course, the only way to test it is to set it up and do it. So now that I've got the machine set up, I now have to work on getting a suitable paper to record on. So I might actually have to smoke some paper. We shall see. So hopefully I can do an experiment later this evening and see if this is actually going to scribe a modulated line. So I just wanted to do a quick video just to document the stylus so you can see how this is set up. As I said, I may have to remake this out of one piece of copper. We shall see. So I just wanted to do a quick video. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.